Tim, welcome to What You Want. Thanks for logging on. Today, we're looking at the Hublot Big Bang Ferrari Titanium 45mm, one of 1,000 built. This limited edition tribute to Scuderia Ferrari blends two iconic luxury names, Ferrari and Hublot. And in a lot of ways, this is the shoe that finally fits. Through several decades of mismanaged marriages to Gerard Perregaux and Panerai, we forgot that Ferrari is inherently a techie brand with a lot of machine appeal to the same kind of gearheads who buy luxury watches. That should be a match made in heaven for any luxury watchmaker, but to date, only Hublot has got it right. And like I said, the shoe fits because Ferrari is a perennial winner. With 221 Grand Prix victories since the 1950s, 207 pole positions, 230 fastest laps, and over 30 combined manufacturer or driver's titles, Ferrari is the dominant player in high-end motorsports, and Hublot strives to be the dominant player in high-end sports watches. Again, this is a merger, a thematic, mechanical merger of two premium machine brands that appeal to gearheads. If you like one, you're probably going to like the other. And fortunately, Hublot does a great job of integrating the two into this Big Bang Ferrari Titanium. Now, the line was new for 2012. Hublot debuted not just its second generation Big Bang, but the first iterations of the Hublot Ferrari watches. Now, by some accounts, these now represent something like 10% of the company's total sales, so they've been a runaway hit with those gearheads who love Ferrari and love watches, and it's easy to see why. First and foremost, you gotta talk about the fit, because if you can't wear the watch, it's hard to love it. And I'm gonna say that even with my 6 1/3 inch, 16 centimeter wrist, the watch fits. Now, it's not necessarily my style, because I'm not a big watch guy, but I can't argue with the comfort, I can't argue with the ergonomics of it. It doesn't hula hoop, it's not loose, it doesn't pinch, and Hublot does a great job of making big watches fit average to even smaller wrists. Like, my wrist is a normal shape, but it's a little bit average size-wise, kind of oval in profile, flattish across the top, and you can see how short the lugs are on this Big Bang Ferrari. It's a 45mm watch, but it doesn't have huge, flared, you know, extensive, expansive lugs. It's not as though the 45mm watch effectively becomes a 60mm watch at the lugs. These are tightly hewed, close-coupled lugs that do a good job of not constraining or projecting the strap outwards. Sometimes when you have a strap like this that conforms to the case, it doesn't want to pull down tight to fit a smaller wrist. It wants to flare out and add virtual diameter or virtual circumference to the case, and I don't like that. On some watches, like some of the 44mm Audemars Piguet Offshores, the strap wants, it just inherently wants a bigger wrist than the nominal size of the watch would suggest. I don't get that feeling with the Hublot. If you can wear a 45mm watch, if you've had success with 44mm Panerai or 42mm Royal Oak Offshore in the past, I would say even if you're comfortable with the new Maxi case or Super case Rolex 40mm sports watches, you're going to like this Big Bang Ferrari and the way it fits. And the second part of that equation is titanium. Titanium is the key to keeping the watch light on the wrist. It feels like a smaller watch, maybe a steel 40 or 42. And that's a key here, because as well as it fits, if a watch feels like a boat anchor on the wrist, it's going to be a distraction. And you only want to notice the watch when you pay special attention to it, when you want to appreciate it. You don't want it to be an obtrusive presence. This watch isn't. Hublot's classic natural rubber strap right here, with a sort of Alcantara suede-like upper and a contrasting red stitch. You can see there in the light what that looks like. It's gorgeous to look at, and it feels a treat on the skin. Very soft, very supple. It is natural rubber. It is vulcanized rubber, but it has almost that super soft feel of silicone. So it's almost like the best of both worlds, the durability of rubber with the softness, the almost gummy-like softness of silicone. A real good effort by Hublot, and true to their roots as a manufacturer of sports watches with natural rubber straps. Now, as you move in towards the case, you can see this is the second generation Big Bang case. It is a little bit bigger than the first by a millimeter or two, and the key thing here is that they've done an even better job of expressing the layers. You have that sapphire on top, you have that bezel, bound by six titanium H-shaped Hublot bezel bolts, and then the bezel itself features several machined-in layers just to accentuate that sandwich look, where every single mechanical component of the case is expressed separately from the case back to the bottom of the case, to the chronograph pushers and the resin composite inserts on the flanks of the case that you see carbon fiber on the facing side. You could see that there's the bezel gasket just below the bezel and on top of the top layer of the case. You can even see how, in automotive fashion, these straps are held in by a seatbelt style single button release, a great design cue that's not only true to the Ferrari associations, but incredibly convenient for do-it-yourself strap swaps at home. So you've got that expression of the machine on the outside. You've also got the expression of machines on the inside. And in a lot of ways, Hublot takes that Unico movement, which is their own in-house manufacturer automatic chronograph movement, and they bear everything. Now, there are two sapphires at play here. The first one is the sapphire crystal that covers the dial. The second one is, in fact, the dial. It might be tempting to call this watch a skeleton dial, but in fact, the Hublot Big Bang Ferrari Titanium features more of a ghost dial. That sapphire is completely see-through. There's no element of it that's been skeletonized. What you're seeing is a straight shot onto the plates of the Unico movement. So on that sapphire, you see the indexes, you see the printing of the chronograph minutes right here at 3 o'clock, you see the numerals, and they're just floating along with that Ferrari Cavallino Rampante, just above the mechanism of the Unico itself. Now, key to the Unico is the column wheel. You can see the column wheel right here at 6 o'clock, just above the 6. That's the actuating mechanism that actually cycles between the stop, the start, and the reset of the chronograph. That's traditional watchmaking, and while Hublot's original chronographs based on the Valjoux 7750 automatic caliber did not feature that refinement, it is standard on all Unico chronograph models, and you get to see it in action when the watch's features are cycled. Just as the dial itself is ghosted, you see that the date ring itself is even a little bit skeletonized. Now, right here at 3 o'clock, there's a yellow disc, and the skeletonized date wheel actually moves over that yellow surface in sequence, highlighting the stencil of the day's date. It's subtle, but it's got a high-impact look and feel to it, and it's a little bit like looking at the gauges of a Ferrari sports car on the dashboard. Very cool, very slick touch. Now, on the case back, the watch features another Ferrari-inspired measure. That's the combination of these lug-nut-like case back bolts and a Ferrari 5-spoke wheel-styled counterweighted automatic winding rotor. Now, it's actually completely circular. The counterweight is hidden under one side, so while it appears completely symmetrical, it will wind the watch quite efficiently. Now, the Unico movement features all the latest standards and then some. The escapement is a silicon assembly that's anti-magnetic, lightly lubricated, very durable, Hublot's proprietary technology. It's also a 4 hertz chronograph, so it's got a modern 28,800 beat per hour beat rate. Very accurate. It maintains its amplitude when the chronograph is running using a unique trick. It runs the minute hand directly off of the barrel so that although it will drain more power from the power reserve, it will maintain the same amplitude, so running the chronograph will not slow down the watch. And with a 72-hour power reserve, substantially more than the industry standard 42, this watch can run the chronograph plenty without depleting its reserves. By the way, I'm going to mention that 72 hours matches the Breitling BO1 chronograph movement, their in-house movement, and the industry standard Rolex Daytona caliber 4130. So Hublot's really shooting for the top players in the industry, swinging for the fences here, endowing the Unico with the feel, the look, and indeed the feature set of a premium chronograph. An easy watch to appreciate from any angle. I particularly like the top and the case back because it lets you look into the soul of the machine. And the soul of the machine is the animus here. It is the spirit that drives the Hublot Big Bang Ferrari collection. This Hublot Big Bang Ferrari Titanium is available with all original boxes, papers, and accessories from Watch You Want. And I really want to give a shout out to this accessory set because it's more than a little special. First and foremost, the famed inner display box that we always mention, in this case, is a display watch winder that will actually keep your Hublot Big Bang Ferrari charged up if you're cycling between other watches in your collection, or if you just want a more formal watch, perhaps during the week when you're not wearing the Big Bang. The bottom line is you get a watch winder when you buy this watch, and it's Hublot branded. Plus, you get a second accessory strap. So it being as easy as it is to pop these straps out using the push-button release, you get started on the strap swapping hobby with a separate Hublot accessory strap, also in rubber, designed to fit this watch and complement its color scheme. Additional accessory straps are available from Hublot if you want to give your watch more makeovers. This Hublot Big Bang Ferrari Titanium 45mm, one of 1,000 limited edition, is available on our website, Watch You Want. I have a feeling that if you like Hublot and you like high-performance cars, I've got the one high-performance machine that'll suit you perfectly, that will be, in a sense, the watch, the wheels you want.